Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied or we have derived an equation which was based on Gibbs free change and the standard Gibbs free change. So now we are going to do a numerical based on that also. So let us see. So before going to the numericals, let us see that what is the question that has been asked in the given one, which says that the following is the redox reaction in a galvanic cell in which 2 moles of aluminium is being reacted with 3 moles of Fe2 plus ion, which has a concentration of 1 molar, and it has been giving the product as 2 moles of Al3 plus 3 moles of Fe. And in this case, we have to write the first thing that we have to write the cell formula. And the next one, that is, we have to calculate what would be the E cell if E naught of anode and E naught of cathode has been provided. And we have to calculate ultimately what would be the delta G naught. So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to mention that in this reaction, which one will be acting as anode as well as which one will be acting as a cathode. 2 moles of aluminium plus 3 moles of Fe2 plus, that is giving us 2 moles of aluminium 3 plus 3 moles of Fe. So in this case, what will happen is the aluminium, which is now being converted into aluminium 3 plus, in this case basically the aluminium which has oxidation state of 0 is now being converted into oxidation state of 3 plus. So in redox reaction also we have studied that the one in which the oxidation number increases, it is nothing but the oxidation process. So therefore this is the oxidation process. While if we observe the Fe2 plus, which is present in the reactant side, is now being converted into Fe, which has an oxidation state of 0. So this is only possible if Fe2 plus has accepted 2 electrons so as to convert from Fe2 plus to Fe, which has oxidation state of 0. So therefore this is a reduction process. So once we have determined that what is where the oxidation reaction takes place and where the reduction reaction takes place, so it is very much easy to evaluate that which one is acting as anode or which one is acting as cathode. So in this case, the anode, the one is the one who shows oxidation process. So in this case, the anode is nothing but the aluminium, while the cathode is the one who undergoes reduction. So in this case, Fe is the electrode which is showing the reduction. So therefore, reduction takes place at cathode itself. So in this thing, the cathode will be Fe. So what would be the overall reaction? So to represent the overall reaction, I could write it as, at anode, since always oxidation reaction takes place in a galvanic cell, so therefore in this case aluminium is being converted into aluminium 3 plus by removing electrons, but the stoichiometry that is being provided to us is 2. So therefore if I multiply this by 2, then the number of electrons will also be multiplied by 2. That's fine. So now let's move towards the next one. If in this case, suppose if I see that at cathode, as you know, overall reaction that takes place in this cathode is reduction. So in this case, Fe2 plus is been converting into Fe0. Fine. So this is only possible, I could write it in this way also. It is only possible if Fe2 plus has accepted 2 electrons. So in this case, but the stoichiometry is been given as 3, so I could write it as, I will multiply this by 3. Similarly, I will multiply 2 electrons by 3 also. And this is the thing. So the thing that we will get cancelled out with each other is 6 electrons. They will cancel out each other, and the answer that I could get it as, or the overall reaction that could get it as it has been provided earlier also, that is 2 moles of aluminium plus 3 moles of Fe2 plus, that should give us 2 moles of Al3 plus plus 3 moles of Fe. So in this case, basically the reaction is already balanced. So the thing that we have did here is to calculate that how many electrons are being involved in a half reaction. So in this case, in this half reaction, the number of electrons were involved were 6. Where in this half reaction also, the number of electrons were involved, which were 6. So this is how we have calculated what would be the value of N. So in this case, the value of N that we have calculated is 6. To represent the cell formula, we have got to know that aluminium is acting as anode while Fe is acting as a cathode. But aluminium is being converted into Al3+, means this means when the solid is being converted into an aqueous form of Al3+, and in this case the aqueous form of Fe2+ is now being converted into solid form of Fe. So the first thing that we have to know that anode should be always represented on the left hand side, and in this case the anode is nothing but the aluminium. So therefore the cell formula can be written as, when aluminium is present at the extreme left while the Fe, which is acting as a cathode, is represented extreme right. Now aluminium, which is of solid state, and A, which is being converted into Al3+. So Al3+ is the one which is present in aqueous state. So the both have aluminium, but the thing is the phase is different. So I could represent it by a vertical line. And talking about the other one, if I talk about the other one, so suppose in this case Fe, which is present in solid form, and in this case Fe2 plus is now being converted into Fe. So therefore I could write it as Fe2 plus is now being converted into Fe. So this is how we have represented it. And talking about this thing, that what would be the cell formula, but in this case since it is for galvanic cell, and galvanic cell might involve semi-permeable membrane, that is the one which is acting like a salt bridge. So I could write, or I could mention here as a single vertical line also, and if a salt bridge has been used, so I could write as a double vertical line also. So this is how we have represented the cell formula. So now let us talk about that, what is, so the first question or the first requirement has been done, and the second requirement is we have to calculate what would be the E cell or E naught cell. So for E naught cell we have a value, that is, or we have a formula, that is E naught cell is nothing but E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode. So in this case the cathode value has been given as minus 0.44 volt, while that of the anode is given as minus 1.66. So therefore minus 0.44 minus of, that is volt, minus of 1.66 volt. So in this case I could write it as 0.44, this minus into minus will be plus, so 1.66 volt. So I could write it as 1.66 minus 0.44, which is nothing but 1.22 volt. So this is how we have calculated. And let me give a brief idea also. If you found that the E naught cell has been positive, that means this is a spontaneous process and the electricity will be generated. And that was a short thing that I have said to you. And talking about the next one, that they have asked for what would be the value of delta G naught. So since we know for delta G naught, we have a formula. That is, it is nothing but minus NF of E naught cell. So, as we know that the value of N, which was been calculated as 6, or we have found it out as 6, that is the number of electrons that is been involved in the half reaction or in the overall reaction. So, it is 6 into F means Faraday constant, which has a value of 96500 into the E naught cell that we have recently calculated as 1.22 volt. So therefore, I will multiply it by 1.22 volt. So let us see what is the answer. So the answer is minus 706380. I could write it as minus 706.380 kilojoule. So this is how we have calculated the value of delta G naught. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got an idea that how can we mention the cell diagram or the cell formula, and we could evaluate the answer regarding when we have got this kind of formulas with us. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and yes, please share this video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.